Today we're going to be running through how you operate a Runxin F67C1 backwash valve, how the settings work, what the accessories are, and what the specs are of the unit. So this is our Runxin F67C1 backwash valve. This is the most popular automatic backwash valves that we sell. We do have a slightly lower cost P1 version as well, which is a little bit more bare bones, but this is generally a very reliable unit and very easy to operate. Our newest spec units, you'll see use these tabs where you can loosen the front of the face of the unit and also the top of the cover in case you need to do internal maintenance. Again, this is not recommended for your normal DIY sort of user, but if you are a professional and you want to look at electronics that may have gone, gears may have gone, we do stock spare parts if you have an issue, but you can very easily replace it without having to use screws like you would have needed to on the previous spec units. With the backwash valve, you in a small bag also receive a very large O-ring. This is what fits underneath between the head and the FRP vessel, and three blue O-rings. Those are used between your fittings in these ports, in the entry, the exit, and the backwash port. We usually recommend that you use the blue O-rings as opposed to something like thread tape, because oftentimes people that are not very familiar with these units will use too much thread tape, because you generally work with quite sort of chunky fittings, and you can risk putting a lot of strain on the valve's fittings itself, and you can even crack them or break them, which is not what you want on an expensive valve like this. So obviously then setting up the unit, as you can see, the unit is flashing, it hasn't been set up yet. So you'll see that there's a small green key. This means that the unit has been locked. This just prevents like children from fiddling with settings and all those sort of things. To unlock the unit, you push the up and the down arrow, you hold it in, and you'll hear a beep. And you see that has then been removed, and the unit is then unlocked and ready to work. So to set up the settings, we push this enter button. You'll see there, this is now flashing. This is the time setting. So obviously this, you'll set it to whatever time you have, just based on just a normal clock. It works on a 24-hour clock system. Then you push enter, then hour to minute. You can then set the minutes, push enter again. You can then go down to your next setting, which is your time. So this is the time that the unit will backwash at. So the default setting is 2 o'clock in the morning. Obviously you can push enter and change this time as you require. Next you go to FWO. You don't need to worry about these, these are generally more advanced settings relating to the amount of time that you'd like it to run cycles. Generally the FWO is the best setting to use out of the box. This will be the frequency of the backwash. So it's going to backwash every third day. If you'd like to change this, you push enter, and you can then change this to whatever you would require. Generally, we do not recommend setting this longer than once every 14 days. Even if it's going to be a very low use system, you're going to want the media to backwash to ensure that there's not bacteria build up inside your vessel. Then next we have the backwash time. So you'll see there's a small icon that shows arrows upwards. So this is how long the backwash is going to be. This is 10 minutes. The backwash time will generally depend on the type of media that you have and the size vessel that you have. Please keep in mind that we would recommend erring on the side of caution. So rather let it backwash for longer than shorter, because sometimes people try and save power, try and save water, and then they have the unit backwash for 3 minutes at a time, which doesn't really backwash whatever unit you have completely clean, and then eventually you'll have buildup inside that unit and the impurities will then bleed through, which is not what you want. Next is our fast rinse. Please also keep in mind that this is very important, because this repacks your media to ensure that you have an effective filtration bed once the water flows through it. So again, we find sometimes that people set this to a minute or 30 seconds, whatever, which is not recommended. You want it to run through for a good couple of minutes to make sure that your media bed is completely compacted, because remember, the next water you get through, this is going to flush through to your drain. The next water you get through is going to flush or run through as filtered water through your system. So if you aren't getting effective filtration here, you can have issues with other vessels, or you are not going to be removing all the impurities that you think you may. Again, the setting is just a BR1 setting. You can leave that as is for the moment. It's usually a more advanced setting. And we are then back at the time. So once you set up everything, you can then just push enter again. Oh, sorry. We can then just push this little finger button. And this means that we are then putting it back into operation. So these lights will pulse up and down once the unit is busy operating. If you then want to run a backwash cycle manually outside of the timed cycle, you see this looks like a little finger that's pointing. You can push this button and you'll hear it is turning onto its backwash cycle. Again, if you set this to run more than one backwash cycle, then this will not display F00, it will display F001 or F002 depending on the cycle that it is at, and it will count down as you go. And then obviously it's backwashing now at the time, for the duration that you've set, and then pushing it again will run through to the fast rinse cycle. Again, running at the duration, there's the fast rinse, the duration that we set previously, and then we can push it again and it will run through and it will go back into operation. So again, if you just push this once, it's going to run through all of those timed steps as you've set it. If you want to fast forward through them, if you want to call it that, you can just push this and we'll skip over to the next setting. Please keep in mind that once you've done that, it will count that as a backwash cycle and then it will reset your time and start again from the beginning. So hopefully this answers your questions that you have with this unit. If you are uncertain about anything else, you're welcome to contact our technical team. You can call us on 021 851 0133 or email us at sales@definitivewater.co.za.